channel, and today we are going to be talking about how to love yourself more and put yourself first. Now, a lot of people, they're gonna be rubbed the wrong way by this video, but understand, if you clicked on this video, you think you're about to get one of those videos where I'm gonna be talking to you softly and putting the inspirational music in the background and playing beautiful images of people running in the wind and walking by the sunset, and you're gonna watch this video and be, you know, so like inspired to do something amazing with your life and all of this goofy shit. Y'all don't seem to listen to those videos either. I'm a different type of person. I'm very realistic and I'm extremely cutthroat, only because this is how I talk. I talk to everybody like this, my mom, my dad, my friends, even my boyfriend get this goddamn treatment. All right, everybody get it the same way. I guess you call it the tough love treatment, whatever. I just call it the common sense treatment. I would hope y'all listen to this, because y'all probably ain't gonna listen to this either. So just understand, I take the approach of realism here, and I'm gonna hurt some feelings. So if you easily offended, it's not the video for you, but you're free to watch any other video I have on this channel. I have like 600 other videos. We do rants, commentaries, and reactions on here, so you're free to click off, okay? This video is specifically for those of you who really want to understand why it's hard for you to love yourself and put yourself first in situations of toxicity. When you know someone cheating on your ass, when you know you got a fake ass friend, when you know you're being used and abused, but some way, somehow, you're just like, damn. There's very common reasons as to why we do this, okay? Now, understand, I've been in all of these situations before, so that's why I'm able to speak on this. Do not think of me as holier than thou or that I'm speaking down on y'all. I have plenty of story times that I have, like, basically spoken about this type of behavior that I've exhibited myself. I also am going to be doing more story times this month. You guys do not know, I'm going to be doing 12 days of story time from December 25th to January 6th. My birthday is January 5th. Comment down below if you're my birthday twin or if you a Capricorn. So, honestly, I know a lot about this. The journey to self-love is way easier said than done. It's one of those things where a lot of people do not grow up with the foundation to love themselves more. But at the same time, I feel like we have to stop playing the blame game. So first things first, I feel like the main reason a lot of us do not love ourselves is because we are conditioned to be selfless. Let's be real. One of the first things they instill in us as children is selflessness. Sharing is caring. When people are teaching their kids the principles of sharing, kindness, forgiveness, numbers, letters, and stuff, self-love is never in that equation. I feel like now, especially Black people are starting to do this, especially with their girls, which is so incredible, but it's still not done as much. There's not many people that are sitting here spending time with their daughters or their sons and sitting there telling them, you are worthy, you are amazing, you are special, you are more important than anyone in this world. There's not anyone doing that, and it's leading to people pleasing behavior, because instead we're telling them sharing is caring, put yourself last, always put yourself in other people's shoes. We're telling them honestly the direct opposite, and it's leading to pretty dangerous behavior that I feel like a lot of people do not think about. All of the concepts that they teach us in preschool, kindergarten, and just primary school are all about helping others, being kind, and everything. And listen, there's absolutely nothing wrong with that, but I feel like it goes a step further, and sometimes I feel like a lot of us take it to the point where we become extremely kind, and some people are very vulture-like. Like, let's be real, we still had bullies in kindergarten, okay, in elementary, that literally sat here and exploited this, okay? Sharing is caring, let me take your lunch money. Sharing is caring, let me get those sneakers. Sharing is caring, oh, well, I'ma cut the line. I'm sure y'all know what I'm talking about. A lot of us will take what we see in the news, on social media, and in society as face value without digging deep and trying to find our own positivity to look forward to. Life is what you make it. So it's all about you, and it's all about what you're trying to find and what you're trying to seek. That was a little tangent, my bad. Let's get back on topic. A lot of us are taught to be selfless. If someone in school does not take advantage of these principles, it's always going to be someone in your home. We've all went through this. this, okay? Sharing is caring. Let me borrow $20. Sharing is caring. Let me borrow $50. Next thing you know, you end up on the People's Court, Judge Mathis Court, or some other court because blood is thicker than water. You should never sue your family members because they're your family. And your family is sacred. Your family is amazing. Your family is always going to be there for you because they are your inherited kin, okay? You love them no matter what. You should never take them to court. How dare you? We all know these concepts. So when you grow up with these types of concepts in your life, it's no wonder that when you start making friends, shit really goes out the fucking window because now you're doing everything for friends. Now, as someone who grew up of Haitian descent, everybody who's Haitian, comment down below. What's the first shit your parents told you about friends? Because I know mine. My mom pa bows on me, pa bows on me. Your mom didn't give you friends. Your dad didn't give you friends. This is why if you ever had a Haitian friend, you see most of them are usually to themselves. Luckily, my parents weren't very strict on that. Like my parents kind of like let me be a free range kid to an extent. Even though my parents were very free range, I ain't go to no sleepovers. You barely saw me at any parties unless it was a school type of party. And yeah, they wasn't playing all that extra goofy shit. I was never really going to movie theaters and stuff like that. Like, you not gonna see them. A lot of people, especially American kids, like in American culture, friends are very important. Movies, sleepovers, parties, outings, it's very, very much so important to have a social life. So when you're having kids that have developed a people pleasing personality because they're used to being so selfless and doing things for other people and putting themselves last, never in the conversation is love yourself a discussion. Let's be real, right? So now when you have all these friends, now we think about peer pressure, which to be honest, I really don't think peer pressure is real. Like, I've talked about this before. I feel like peer pressure exists in terms of like idol, right? Like, I feel like when it comes to celebrities, when it comes to media, but that's not peer pressure. I think there's another word for that. But I feel like when it comes to friends, it's like, bro, like, you wanted to do that shit. Your friends can't tell you to do anything unless they put a gun to your head. That's just my personal opinion on it. But anyhow, when it comes to a lot of other people think peer pressure is real. I know there's studies on it, whatever. So peer pressure, right? When it comes to peer pressure, when it comes to, you know, people doing things around you and you're a teenager and literally you want to be cool, you want to stand out and stuff like that, it's a lot harder to sit there and be like, yeah, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do that, etc. Because at this point, it's like, I want to do this to fit in, especially when, you know, your hormones are all over the place, your mind is not fully developed, so it's completely understood. And plus, they're kids, right? But of course, people don't see these kids as kids anymore, and it's just very unfortunate. And a lot of people don't really understand, especially because, like, as adults, I feel like we kind of forget what it's like to be a teen. A lot of people start putting all of these pressures on these kids and all these responsibilities on these kids, especially if they grew up in lower income neighborhoods or anything like that. It's like they have so much responsibilities on top of being a regular teenager. When you put all of that together, there is no room for self-care. Now, when you're putting in other sensitive situations like relationships, oh my God, everything goes out the fucking window. And this is where the whole self-love conversation really takes a twist and really takes a turn. Not only are you being mostly abused by your family, your parents, your friends, but now you're getting into relationships and you probably think all of this other behavior from everyone in your life is probably normalized. But now you get into the situation where now you're in a relationship and you can't really determine what's healthy and what's not. God forbid you come from a household where your mom was always getting beat up or your dad was always getting verbally abused or you didn't have a dad or you didn't have a mom, or like you were growing up in a toxic household or you didn't have a household where you had a mom and dad. Maybe you were just raised by a grandmother, so you didn't have any direct representation of love at all. So now you get thrown into a relationship, or you get into a relationship where it's like you don't know what love is supposed to look like, and you go and you tell your partner that. Understand, stop doing that. One way to fuck up your self-love journey is to go around trauma bonding with people. Stop telling people. I should do a full video on trauma bonding. Stop telling people people your business. Don't tell people how you grew up. Don't tell people about your parents. Don't tell nobody shit, because they're gonna use that shit against you. They're gonna weaponize it. And a lot of people don't know they're doing it. That's the crazy part. A lot of people don't know. Like, oh, okay, well, he doesn't have a mom. All right, well, I can use him. As people that have been victimized by this, we look at it as vindictive. We look at it as, oh, this person ain't shit. And even at that, a lot of us, when we're in a situation, we're not even looking at it like that. But when we're telling our friends and family, clearly they can see the paradox, but we don't. Stop that shit. And it's just crazy how much information people divulge into relationships that are so meaningless and short-lived for entirely no reason. If it's not something you will put on social media, don't tell your damn person. You may think that something happened one way, but then over time, when years pass, you're like, okay, maybe I was really mad about this one thing, but I'm not that mad anymore, or I'm not that, you know, upset about this. You know, sometimes some things happen one way, but it's really another way. Or sometimes you may think that you really hate yourself for one reason, and, you know, you may have think someone did something to you, but they really didn't do that, or something was just a misunderstanding and you just needed a different outlook on that situation. Sometimes a relationship is the reason why we may see ourselves a certain way. We may have been cheated on. We may have been abused. We may have literally had something happen to us in a relationship and thought, okay, was I not good enough? Was I not worthy? Did this person cheat on me because I was, you know, ugly, dirty, stinky? So now you start thinking, what am I? Am I not a good enough man? Am I not a good enough woman? Am I not a good enough person? Like, am I not enough? You know, is anyone gonna want me? And sometimes you just need to revisit a situation and just not be so hard on yourself. You need to just start thinking, okay, why do I feel this way? What happened? Etc. It's all about what you have to do for you. Everyone needs to focus on what they have to do for themselves, because at the end of the day, you are going to be the only one to answer to your issues. What happens to you is all that really matters. You cannot sit here and keep blaming other people and keep waiting for other people to bring you somewhere, because it's not going to work. The days are getting longer, everyone else is getting stronger, and you're doing absolutely nothing. You may be mad at me, I may sound like an asshole, that person may have hurt you, and all of that is absolutely correct. But you know what's also correct? You're doing absolutely nothing about it, and you're letting your life pass you by. Take that anger and go to therapy. Take that anger and start doing some work on yourself. Order a planner, go get some Dollar Tree plates, throw them at the fucking ground. Do some work, do something. Because at the end of the day, you're going to have to look at yourself and say, oh my God, I did nothing. It's been 10 years and I've been depressed and I did nothing about this shit. You cannot sit here and keep blaming other people for your mishaps, because you sat here and you let the other people win. Yes, I said the other people win. You don't love yourself because someone sought out for you to lose. Whether that is your parents, sadly, they do not always have your best interests at heart. Your other family members, yeah, sometimes they envy you. Your friends, let's be real, a lot of times they're not your friends. Someone you got in a relationship with, let's be real, you shouldn't be in a relationship with them anyway. They wanted you to fucking lose, whether it was their intentions or not, consciously or subconsciously. And when you sit there, bitch, cry, complain, and do nothing, you let them win. You can't literally have all the toxic things in place that you've been doing and think that all of these things are gonna go and just magically fix themselves. Now, honestly, the main reason a lot of people choose to stay in toxic situations that really fucks up their self-love journey is because of the sunk cost fallacy and time. Now, the sunk cost fallacy is literally you choosing to stay in a situation because you have time invested into it, and because you're just like, okay, well, I've already spent my time, so what is the worst that can happen? I don't like college. I don't really care for this degree, but I'm gonna stay here anyway because I've already invested a year into it. So let's see where it goes. Sound familiar? I really don't like this girl, but you know, we've been together for 6 months. I don't have any kids with her. I don't really got a house with her. I mean, I don't even think I'm gonna marry her, but I'm gonna stay with her anyway because, I mean, we've been together for 6 months, so I mean, hey, fuck it. Sound familiar? Stop doing that shit. Time is not an excuse to waste more time with something or someone that you know damn well you don't want to be with. The next one is confrontation. A lot of people are very much so afraid of confronting someone that they do not fuck with anymore, or that they do not want to fuck with anymore. They're like, you know, I don't want drama, I don't want a scene, I don't want to cause no issues. And it's just like, you already causing issues in your life, you already fucking with somebody that you don't want to be fucking with, you already doing all of this goofy shit. I don't even understand. You're complaining about them every day, you're literally sitting here mad all the time that you're friends with them and they're doing this, that, and the third to you. Like, honestly, if we're having this conversation right now, you clicked on this video because you know you're dealing with somebody that you know you shouldn't be fucking with, and literally, you know damn well you don't love yourself enough to cut them off. Confrontation should be the least of your worries, because at this point your life is full of turmoil anyway. Okay, understand, you need to be comfortable with confrontation as an adult. Whether you have anxiety, whether you have some sort of, whatever the case, mental illness, understand you need to go get psychological help with that, because as an adult especially, you need to learn that you cannot just run to the defense of your I have a mental illness to combat or avoid some sort of confrontation or anything else that you're trying to avoid. You have to learn how to deal with things, because this is not okay. Okay, if you are having someone that is hurting you, if someone is out here fucking with your well-being, you have to be able to say, not okay, fuck it. All right, it doesn't have to be messy, it doesn't have to be a scene, it doesn't have to be all of that goofy shit. But I will tell you that if you have to make it a text message, if it has to be an email, if it has to be a face-to-face confrontation, do whatever it is that is more comfortable for you. They may be upset, they may be mad, you just may have to distance it for a while, just let the shit die. But whatever it is, don't let anyone take away your form of communication and your form of confrontation. It is what it is. Caring about what other people think is going to be the demise of a lot of people. That's going to be another video for another time. Stop caring about what other people think so fucking much. If people stopped caring about what other people thought, the world would be a better place. Why do you care so much about what other people gonna think about how you confronted them? Who the fuck cares? You don't care about them anymore anyway. And honestly, you shouldn't care about them anywhere, because they're causing so many problems in your life. So if you're afraid of breaking up with the person, if you're afraid of cutting them off as a friend, if you're afraid of telling your mom, your dad, your cousin, your uncle, your aunt, or whatever, that you do not want to have communication with them anymore, you're moving away because they're toxic, fuck it. Who cares? What other people think about you is none of your business. You need to put that on your wall. I should put that shit on a shirt. That's what I live by. I don't give a flying fool shit. And the last one is religion. Now, this one really goes into marriage and more so relationships. A lot of people are always like, you know, I don't want to divorce him, I don't want to this, that, and the third. Even if he's beating the shit out of me, even if he's abusing me in any other type of way, even if he's a horrible husband, the Lord said I shall stay with my husband, blah 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 blah. I understand that, right? I respect people's beliefs, but I never ever in my life seen God say thou shalt be a dumb bitch, thou shalt let people abuse me, thou shalt let people walk all over me, thou shalt let men take my money, thou shalt let all stupid shit happen to me. I don't got time for that. I literally went to Catholic school, been to so many different types of Christian churches. I've never seen any type of scripture that said anything like let people abuse me, use me, and throw me out like garbage. And a lot of these women especially love to do that bullshit where they sit here and advocate for men. Like, advocate for men. Talk about some, oh, well, God wouldn't like if I got a divorce. I don't think God would like if you sat here and got your ass beat either. Better yet, I don't think God would like you putting your kids in a toxic and potentially dangerous situation either. I just don't understand. I can't tell you guys how many situations I've been in where women have sat there and put their children in horrible situations. Love yourself more to say enough is enough. Love yourself more, at least for your children if you have them. Because this is fucking ridiculous and the cycle is going to repeat. Y'all, I'm begging you. If you have not embarked on your self-love journey, or just choosing yourself more, whether it's cutting off friends or just, you know, just saying no more to things that you don't want to do, I strongly advise it. You deserve it. You deserve way more than you are giving yourself. Give yourself more grace. Do better things for yourself. Take yourself out to eat. Instead of eating a piece of fruit and some toast, why not go out and get yourself some fucking pancakes? Okay, like, you know, instead of sitting here moping around watching Netflix in bed, take a fucking walk. You know, it's the little things, yo. The little things. Instill a self-care routine. Set some goals. Take yourself out. Actually get dressed by yourself, you know? Don't rely on no one. Take a trip alone. And I know there's a lot of people that have concerns about that, especially women. They're like, oh my God, I can't
can't travel alone. Yes, you can. There's thousands of women who travel alone all the time. I went on a cruise by myself, for crying out loud. You can do it. You can do anything you want to do because you said you can. With that being said, make sure you guys comment down below. What are your thoughts and opinions on self-love? What was your self journey like? What prompted you to start your self-love journey? When did you realize you didn't love yourself? And yeah, what did you think about this video? Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye!